Establishing a standardized structure for your data science project makes it easy for your teammates to maintain and modify your project. But what kind of standard should you follow? Wouldn't it be convenient to have a template that outlines an ideal structure for your data science project? That is why I created a repository named Data Science Template. In this video, you will learn how to use this template to incorporate best practices into your data science workflow. To download the template, start with installing CookieCurder. Next, create a new project based on the specified template. After executing the command, you will be prompted to provide some details about your project, such as project name, author name, and compatible Python version. Now, a project with the specified name is created in your current directory. The structure of the project looks like the following. In the next few sessions, we will go over the tools used in this project and their functionalities. Poetry is a Python dependency management tool. Poetry is a better alternative to pip for several reasons. Firstly, it stores the flexible versions of packages in the pyproject.tom file, ensuring that your project can adapt to newer releases. Secondly, it stores the exact version numbers of each package and its dependencies in the poetry.log file, ensuring the reproducibility of dependencies. Thirdly, it efficiently resolves dependencies and addresses any conflicts promptly, and more. To activate a new environment, run poetry shell. To install all dependencies, run poetry install. To add a new library, run poetry add library name. To remove a library, run poetry remove library name. When committing your Python code to Git, it is crucial to ensure that the code follows consistent style guides such as proper code usage, f-string usage, and standardized imports to promote easier code review processes. It's also crucial to ensure that the code includes docstrings to enhance the readability of your code. However, verifying all these criteria manually before each commit can be overwhelming. Thus, this template uses pre-commit to automate this process. Pre-commit executes hooks specified in the pre-commit config.yam file to identify simple issues before committing the code. This template uses two hooks. The first one is ruff, which is an extremely fast Python linter. It supports 500 linked rules. The second one is interrogate, which checks your codebase for missing docstrings. To add pre-commit to Git hooks, type pre-commit install. Now, whenever you run Git commit, your code will be automatically checked and reformatted before being committed. Mac file allows you to create short commands for repetitive tasks that usually involve multiple steps, such as environment setup. There are two targets in this Mac file. One target is to Mac dependencies, and another one is to Mac the environment. The dependencies target initializes a new Git repository, installs the project dependencies, and sets up pre-commit hooks. The environment target executes the dependencies target first, then activates the virtual environment created by Poetry. To set up the environment for your projects, authors can simply execute a single command. It is essential to avoid hard coding as it gives rise to various issues. Firstly, if values are scattered throughout the code base, updating them consistently becomes harder. Secondly, hard coding values limits the reusability of code for different scenarios. Thirdly, hard coding sensitive information like passwords or API keys directly into the code can be a security risk. Lastly, hard-coded values can make texting and debugging more challenging. Configuration files solve these problems by storing parameters separately from the code. Among the numerous Python libraries available for creating configuration files, Hydra stands out as my preferred configuration management tool because of its impressive set of features, including convenient parameter access, command line configuration override, and more. Suppose the main.yaml file located in the config folder looks like this. Within a Python script, you can effortlessly access a configuration file by applying a single decorator to your Python function. By using the dot notation, you can conveniently access specific parameters from the configuration file. To override configuration from the command line, type Python, the name of the file, and the new value for the parameter in the configuration file. Storing large binary files directly in Git can lead to increased repository size and slower Git performance. Thus, we use DVC, which stands for Data Version Control, to keep track of different versions of the data in Git while storing the original data in a separate location. To track changes to the data directory, type dvc-add-data. This command will create the data.dvc file, which contains a unique identifier and the location of data directory in the file system. To keep track of data associated with a particular version, commit the data.dvc file to Git. To push the data to the remote storage, type dvc-push. This template leverages pdoc to generate API documentation based on the doc string of your Python files and objects. To create documentation for your project, run macdocs. The documentation is now saved as macdoc files, and you can access it by opening localhost A0A0 in your web browser. This documentation will make it easier for your teammates to understand your code. This template is designed to be flexible. Feel free to adjust the project based on your applications. For a more in-depth understanding of Poultry, Hydra, and DVC, I recommend watching the linked videos in the description of this video. Building a robust framework for your data science project is only the first step to building a reliable machine learning pipeline. To ensure a smooth deployment of your code and model, the next step is to automate code and model testing after submitting the pull request. In this next video, you will learn how to construct a continuous integration pipeline for your machine learning project.